Hey guys, it's Mike Chen. I thought about this topic when I was reading on the news that there are some deep sea divers who could hold their breath for 5 or even up to 10 minutes. And I was thinking, this is insane. I mean, I can barely hold my breath for 30 seconds before almost blacking out. And if people can indeed train themselves to hold their breath for so long, is it possible that humans could eventually be, I don't know, be like fish and survive underwater? Well, surprisingly, evidence has emerged showing this aquatic fact is kind of true. I mean, we're way off from being able to breathe in water like, I don't know, mermaids, but one tribe certainly knows what they're doing when it comes to spending long periods in the briny deep. The Bajau people were first mentioned in the 16th century via the journal of pioneering Venetian explorer Antonio Pigafetta. They're native to Indonesia and also the southern Philippines and Malaysia. The tribe relies on the water for their way of life, collecting meals from the seabed. Of course, this means they spend an awful lot of time submerged in the wet stuff. In fact, diving is a full-time occupation for them. The Bajau reportedly devote 8 hours a day to going underwater with only a mask and a weight to keep themselves in position. And they can stay underwater for over 13 minutes. So how come this tribe can hold their breath under surface for longer than the average person? Well, the answer lies in human biology. You see, the Bajau possesses a certain something about them that makes them excellent at surviving in the water. That certain something is an enlarged spleen. Now, if you don't know, the spleen is a versatile organ that is found in your abdomen. It's known for recycling old red blood cells in addition to storing white blood cells. There are a lot of other things that does too, but the point is, the spleen plays an essential role in how the Bajau last in the drink. Have you ever heard of the human dive response? It's basically when you go through a process where your heart rate is reduced and your blood vessels shrink. And this is done on the outer reaches of your body to keep oxygenated blood where it's seriously needed in your organs. The spleen then contracts, pumping out oxygenated red blood cells and supplying you with extra oxygen. So with their bigger than average spleens, the Bajau can take it to the limit for their underwater exploits. Now, a logical explanation for these spleens is that the Bajau are always diving, so their bodies adapted accordingly, right? That is a nice idea, but not entirely accurate. Scientific studies show that the enlarged spleens were present in those who dived, but also in those who didn't. That means the enlarged spleens are genetic and not acquired. And this is really interesting because I did a topic in the past about a tribe who has better eyesight than anybody else on the planet, and now this tribe has better lung capacity than anybody else on the planet. So it makes you wonder if there are other types of quote unquote superhumans out there, maybe or a group of super people who can maybe, I don't know, walk around in incredibly high temperatures or can tolerate severe cold. And it also says a lot about the human mind and the body. It really makes you think, what are the limits of what we can or cannot do? Perhaps all these superpowers are hidden within us already and it just takes training or a radioactive spider to bring them out. As always guys, thank you all so much for watching this video. I'll see you later.